What if you have four terms that you need to factor? We can use a process called factoring by grouping, where you split the terms into two groups, find the greatest common factor of each, and then combine them. So for example, if you have 12x cubed minus 9x squared plus 8x minus 6, you split it up into two groups, so the first two terms and the last two terms, and find the greatest common factor of each one. So 12 and 9 have a 3 in common, x cubed and x squared have an x squared in common. We can factor out a 3x squared and see what's left over. Well, 3 times 4 gives us 12, and x squared times x gives us x cubed. Then 3 times negative 3 gives us negative 9, and we already have the x squared there. So that's all we have for the first group. For the second group, 8 and negative 6 have a positive 2 in common, and then again, see what we get left over. So 2 times 4 gives us 8, and we still have an x, and 2 times negative 3 gives us. And what you'll notice is that we have 3x squared multiplying 4x minus 3, and 2 also multiplying 4x minus 3. So essentially what we have is 3x squared plus 2 that are both multiplying 4x minus 3. So we can factor it that way. So this also works if you have a what looks like a random assortment of variables. So we can basically split it up into two groups and then factor the greatest common factor of each. But before we do that, I want you to notice that actually there is a greatest common factor between all four of them. So whenever there's greatest common factor, it will always make your life easier to factor that out first. So 7 goes into all of it. And if I check the variables, none of the terms, they don't all have the same variable. So 7 is the only factor between all four. So 7 goes into 224, 7 goes into 22 three times with one left over, and then 7 goes into 14 two times, and you still have an A and a Z. 7 goes into 58, 6, eight times, and then you still have an A and a C. 7 goes into 8 one time with one left over, and 7 goes into 14 two times, and you still have a Y, Z. And 7 goes into 21 three times, and you still have a Y, C. Okay. Then we can factor by grouping. So again, this will be our first group and this will be our second group. So in our first group, we have an 8 as the greatest common factor, and they also both have an A. So then we look at what's left over. So 8 times 4 gives us 32, and A times Z gives us AZ. Then 8 times 1 will give us the 8. We already have the A and we still need a C. And for the second group, basically, we want to follow whatever sign the first term of the second group is. So since that's a negative, we want this to be a minus. So we're going to factor out a negative, and 12 and 3 have a 3 in common, and they also have a y in common. Okay, so we're factoring out a negative 3y. So negative 3 times 4 gives us negative 12, and we still need a z. And negative 3 plus 1 gives us negative 3, and we still need a C. And then you'll notice that we have 8a multiplying 4z plus 1c, and we also have negative 3y multiplying 4z plus 1c. So what we basically have is we have 8a minus 3y. These are both multiplying 4z plus c. We don't really need to write the 1. And we still have the 7 multiplying all of it.